So we'll be talking about this painting by Clara Peeters from the 17th century. This is a still life, meaning a painting of inanimate objects. It's oil on panel, meaning it's oil painting, painted on a piece of wood. It was painted in 1611. So first, let's just talk about what we see here. What are we looking at? And we'll go from left to right. So here we see a gray, ivory-colored earthenware jug, and it's holding this floral arrangement with a variety of colorful flowers. Some of them are blossoming, some of them are already open. Their placement attempts to be natural, it attempts to look real, although it might end up feeling a little bit artificial because the sparse distribution and the exaggerated curves of the stems really allow us to get a clear view, a clear frontal view of each different type of flower and plant. And this reminds us of one of the main visual sources for still life paintings, scientific illustrations. And scientific illustrations were actually a specialty in Antwerp where this was painted. When an illustrator painted a scientific illustration of a plant or an animal, of any kind of specimen, the most important thing was to be able to see, to be able to identify what was being painted. And it resulted in these realistic, informative representations with clear frontal views, just like those that we see here in this arrangement. Below the jug, we can see that these flowers, this detail here of the stem and the flower that are just about to fall off the stone slab. And this is one of the ways that the artist is trying to add to an illusion of reality. Here in the center axis of the painting, we have this sumptuous golden goblet. And on the top, we have a little figure with a shield and a spear. Behind the goblet, there's a porcelain dish holding a variety of different products. We have almonds, dates, sugar candy, raisins. All of these would have been expensive imports in 17th century Antwerp. And if we look at the pewter dish here in the foreground, we can see more of the same products and pretzels as well. And this half-eaten pretzel gives us the feeling that someone might have just been at this table. Someone might have just been here and took a few bites of this pretzel and put it back down. So again, this is a way that the artist is adding to the illusion of reality. Behind the dish, we have a pewter pitcher. And here we're going to want to take time to look up close because Clara has painted reflections. And first and foremost, just appreciate the technical skill that goes in to painting reflections. And she's included the window of the room she's painting in. And if you look closely enough, you can see that she has included miniature self-portraits. There are at least, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe even 6 of them here on the picture. And then there's actually some on the goblet as well. There's one here on the goblet. And there might be another one here near the foot. I'm not sure if this is one or not. Let's see. Behind the pewter pitcher, we have a delicate fluted glass holding wine. This is actually a type of Italian glassware that was popular in Antwerp at the time. So again, both the glass and the wine in it are expensive imported items. We don't know really anything about who Clara Peeters was. We don't know anything about her biography, and everything that we know of her comes from her paintings. We do know that it would have been very difficult to be a woman artist in the 17th century, and it wasn't very common. To become a master artist, meaning to have a workshop and to work professionally as an artist, an apprentice would have to live with a master artist for years as a young teenager. And this would have been very compromising for a young woman to do. And it's one of the reasons that a lot of the women artists that we know today actually come from a family of painters where this kind of training could take place at home. We also know that she often signed her works in a conspicuous way. sometimes on a stone slab in front of the painting, and other times on an intricate silver knife. There's not one of these knives in these paintings, so we're going to go to another painting here to see an example of one of these. Right here, this same knife appears in at least 6 of her known paintings. It could even be a knife that she really owned. All right, let's go back to this one. Clara's realistic style, based on direct observation, was part of a new style at the end of the 16th and beginning of the 17th centuries that moved away from idealism. Her embrace of this new visual language, moving away from idealism, especially in the context of Antwerp, where Peter Paul Rubens' highly idealized work reigned supreme, probably would have felt very modern. And this really makes her an innovative and forward-thinking artist for her time.
And Whitney is not considered to be a vanitas, is it?
Right. There are, there's a lot of thinking that all still life paintings have to have symbolic meanings and moralistic content, because there is a type of still life painting called vanitas paintings that have references to death, the fragility of life, warnings against vanity, and these are called vanitas paintings from vanity. However, there is no evidence that this painting was ever meant to be seen as anything more than a demonstration of technical excellence, an illusion of reality, and a product that would appeal to a high-end buyer. And Clara Peeters did, in fact, have very high-end clientele. This painting comes from the Royal Collection, where it was first listed in the inventories of Elizabeth Farnese, Isabel de Farnesio, who was the second wife of King Philip V of Spain. And they've stayed in the Royal Collection until now.
That we have. This is the sign.
There it is.
Okay, Whitney, thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much for everyone for joining us, and we thank you from the American Friends at the Prado Museum. We hope that you enjoyed our Wednesday conversations, and that you'll take the time to go to our website of the American Friends of the Prado Museum to find out more about our mission and our projects, and maybe ways that you can get involved too. And if you're in Spain, or if you prefer to speak Spanish, you can also look at the website of the Fundación Amigos del Museo del Prado. And thank you to the Prado Museum for letting us participate in your wonderful digital programming. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Whitney.